Hi there, and welcome to our video on a receipt bank walkthrough by PJCO accountants. So today I'm just going to show you through the web version of receipt bank and how to deal with expenses once you've got them into receipt bank using either your camera mode via the receipt bank app or emailing the address in through your customized emailing receipt bank address. So what we see here is the newest version of receipt bank's inbox. So we'll see up here, we've got an option to revert to the old layout if we wanted to, but for today, I'm going to talk you through the new layout. So we've got all of our receipts in here, and at the moment, we'll see that we've got a few older receipts in here, and we are just going to work through a couple of these. So we'll see on the left-hand side that we've got a status for some of them saying ready, and that means that everything that Receipt Bank needs to post through to QuickBooks has been selected already. So that would mean that the category is there and the payment section of the receipt is also ready to push through. But we want to just double check some of these. So for example, I'm going to look at this one which says ready, although it says object not found. So I'm just going to click onto this one and we'll see the receipt that we've emailed in. And all I want to do is just check on the right hand side to make sure Receipt Bank has picked it up all correctly, which it will have. And the category, so this is for a hotel, so I'm going to leave that as traveling and subsistence. And I just want to check the amount, so we got total amount as £180, so £150 plus 20% VAT. And then this payment section is the next part we want to change. So the key part here is kind of recreating exactly what's happened. So if you've paid for this expense already, then we can leave this as paid yes. We want to say it was paid by whichever account you paid for it out of. So for this one, we're going to say the business current account. And when you select a payment account, credit card is going to be the default published to, even if it's not a credit card will be the one that you use for any card payments. So once we're happy with that, we'll see a publish button down the bottom. And we can just put publish in there. For this one, we've got some line items options on there. So I'm just going to total these up so that we can get this receipt ready to publish through. So I'm going to select travel. I'm going to select 150 as the net amount, £30 as the tax amount, and we'll now see that the line items match the item total. So we can click done down the bottom here and we'll see that that is now ready to publish. So I can click publish there and it's now being queued for publishing. So that will then be pushing through to QuickBooks and you'll be able to find that in your QuickBooks account. The error has come up here just because this is a dummy account. So the next receipt that it's put us onto is a Sainsburys receipt for diesel. So already we've got Sainsburys, we've got the date, and we've got traveling as selected as the category. So I'm happy with that, we can leave traveling there. Just want to check that the amount's picked up correctly. And here we've got a nice little VAT summary. So we've got a total VAT amount in there as well. And again, with this payment section, what we want to do is recreate exactly what's happened. So with fuel, you will have paid for it on the spot. So we can leave paid as yes. We want to tick the correct card. So here we can see the end of the card number. So if you've got your receipt bank set up with your card number in the reference section of your payment methods, Receipt Bank will recognize that card number and automatically select the payment method for you. But in this case, that card has not been set up. So I'm just going to select personal card for this payment method. And when we do that, it's going to automatically select credit card as published to, and we'll then be able to publish the item. And the next receipt that we're brought onto is an invoice from Eventbrite. So what we can see here is invoice date 21st of April. And what this could be, if the invoice date was the 21st of April, and then the due date was say a month later, you may not then pay for the invoice on the spot. So we want to change this one slightly. So the category, we're just going to have a scroll through here, see what we've got set up in our QuickBooks account, and we're going to select networking as the expense category. What we've got here, some of the details that you've entered might set up a rule for this supplier. So what that's saying is do you want Brighton and Hove Radio LTE to always be set to networking, and a few more rules that we can also add to it, such as is it always paid in the same way? But we're going to click maybe later on that one. So we got the total amount, and Receipt Bank's picked up the VAT breakdown as well. So that's perfect. So what we want to do now is obviously we see here that this button now says pay no, and we're going to leave it like that because we're going to pay it a week later. So if we click paid no, that means obviously there isn't a payment method in here. So it does then mean that we've got to change this publish to bill. And when we publish this as an unpaid bill, it's going to publish into QuickBooks as money that is still owed from yourself to the supplier. So if I click publish, we'll then be in your QuickBooks account, and the payment can then be recorded when it comes out of your bank account at whatever point you then pay the invoice. So that will be how to publish through a few different examples. When I mentioned the payment methods being set up correctly, on the left hand side here we've got a few different options under lists, but if I click on more lists, a few more pop up and we've got payment methods here. So when I mention the reference number, these four digits here will be the last four digits of your long card number. And if you set up, for example, a personal card with the last four digits of that, and then your business debit card, you can then get Receipt Bank to be a bit more automated and get it working quickly so that it involves less editing every time you put a receipt into it. It's key that you set up these bank accounts to link correctly in QuickBooks. So for example, with the business debit card here, we've got the business current account connected. And with the personal card, we've got a director's loan account. So this bank account here just relates to what the account is called in QuickBooks. And the cost section of Receipt Bank will be the main section that you use when publishing through to QuickBooks. But there are lots of different other features to Receipt Bank that you can use as well, such as supplier rules, which I mentioned previously when that popped up. So if I click into suppliers, and then if I go to AXA, for example, we'll have this supplier rules option to pop up. And what we can say here is that we can select a category. So if we say that AXA is always going to be insurance, and we're always going to pay for it out of the business current account, which means we can select that as the payment method. So we can then select credit card as the publish to and paid as yes. We know with insurance that every time it comes through, it's going to be exempt from VAT. So once we've got this in here, every time Receipt Bank now sees AXA, it will be able to select all of this detail for you, and you can just click onto it and click publish. If you wanted it to go through automatically to QuickBooks, this auto publish option is in there for you as well. So as soon as Receipt Bank sees a receipt from AXA, it will select the category as insurance, the payment method to be paid by the business current account, and the tax rate to be exempt, and it will automatically publish into QuickBooks. So that is the best way to set up rules within Receipt Bank. And another feature of Receipt Bank is expense reports. So expense reports are very good, and you can set them up to be created automatically. So say, for example, you had a pay run that runs from the first of the month to the last day of the month, you can set up what are called effortless expense reports in Receipt Bank to run each month. So if we want to say they're created monthly, I can then go to next, and let's pick the end date as the 30th of September or the end of the month. So I'm going to tick end of month here. And then we can say, who do we want as users to be able to use the expense report? So I'm just going to tip myself in there. And then, do you want to include inbox items that have already been submitted? So that's saying that if you've already submitted a receipt and it's sitting in the inbox, do you want it to then be moved to this receipt expense report? So I'm going to say yes, just in case there are any in there, and I'll click create. So what we'll now see is an expense report for myself covering the period to the end of September. And we've got one in there. So if I click on this, we've got a mileage trip from Shoreham to Brighton. And I'm just going to go back. So that will mean the total of my expense report is £3.60. At the end of the month, so once that date's passed, I can then click on this box and click submit for approval. And when I submit that for approval, you can pick your expense approver, submit it to them, and once they've approved the expense report, you can then pay the employee that reimbursement of their expenses. These effortless expense reports, they can be set up to be automated so that they are created each month, and it will be any time, for example, I submit a receipt, it will go straight into my expense report for the period that is included. If you would like to know any more about any other features of Receipt Bank, just let me know. My email address is tom@peterjarman.com, and I would be glad to hear from you. Thank you for watching today. Bye.